Let's make a chain of bones move like a snake. In Blender 2.79, numpad 7 and 5 for top orthographic view. X to delete the cube. Shift A to add a path. Tab into edit mode and edit the path. A to select all and F to scale. Tab out of edit mode and Shift A to add a single arrow. R, Y, 90 to rotate. Add a follow path constraint. Use the eyedropper tool to select the target path. Follow curve and select the correct forward axis. Set the offset to something like negative 60 for now. Shift D and enter to duplicate. Offset the duplicate arrow to negative 40. Lather, rinse, repeat. Offset negative 20. Offset 0. Shift A to add a cylinder. RY90 to rotate. S Shift X to make it narrow. Tab into edit mode. Control R and mouse wheel to add loop cuts. Tab out of edit mode and add an armature. RY negative 90 to rotate. Turn on X-ray to see the bone through the mesh. Tab into edit mode and subdivide the bone with two cuts. S to scale. Tab out of edit mode. Right-click the cylinder, then the armature, and Control P to parent with automatic weights. Right-click the armature. Go to pose mode and check it out. So bendy. Add a copy location constraint to the head bone. Use the eyedropper tool and select the head arrow. Add a track 2 constraint. And track to the preceding arrow. Add a track 2 constraint to the next bone. And track to the next arrow. Lather, rinse, and repeat. Now change the follow path offset for each of the pertinent arrows, so the tail of each arrow aligns with the tail of its respective bone. Oh, that's satisfying. Now right-click the path and press the data tab. And voila! Hover over evaluation time and press I to keyframe accordingly. Whee!
Why didn't you just use a curve modifier?
Because I'm a rogue, baby!